this thing happened, maybe this thing happened to you before, guys, whereby when you check your bank statement, the bank took the amount by mistake. It can happen. Or maybe when you check your bank statement, you realize that no, someone paid 20,000 in my bank account. Guys, what are you gonna do if you see 20,000 received in your bank account? What are you gonna do? I just wanna see, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna call the bank and say you made a mistake? Or are you, just tell me, be honest with me, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do if you see 20,000 on your bank statement received? Because I know if you see 20,000 paid out of your bank statement, I know what you are going to do. You listen, I know, okay, you're gonna transfer it to the personal account. Can you see, normally, people just use it, but in business, you need to inform the bank and say, here is the error, please rectify it. Can you see now? So, what I'm trying to say is the fact that sometimes you can find that there are errors made. Either the errors can either be made by us in our books, by our accountants and bookkeepers, or sometimes errors can be made by the bank itself. You need to be careful when you find the error. When you find the error, you need to rectify the error. But it depends. So if, for example, let me write it down here. Just gonna change the color maybe to make it a little bit visible. I'm just gonna put it at the bottom here. So if the error is found, in our books, that's why I'm writing it in our books. Errors found in our books should be corrected in our books. So guys, I'm just trying to use simple English so that you can understand what I'm trying to say. Okay. If you found errors, like you can see here, ladies and gentlemen, if you find errors in our books, by our books, guys, I'm referring to this is our books, cash receipts, cash payment. If you find errors here, you must correct the errors here. But don't worry, I'm going to talk about examples of those errors. So if you find the error in our books, you correct it in our books. But if you find error on the bank statement, let me write it down here. Errors found on the bank statement because of space here, I'm gonna as found on the bank statement, I'm just gonna put it down here, must be or should be corrected in. I'm just going to write, because of space, guys, I'm just going to write BRS. I'm going to explain what is BRS. So if you find the error on the bank statement, that error must be corrected in the bank reconciliation statement. So write it down from your side there, guys, because I don't have space here. So if the error is found on the bank statement, we are going to correct it in the statement called bank reconciliation statement. So I'm going to show you how does the bank reconciliation statement look like. Now, so BRS, write it down there, stands for bank reconciliation statement. So for now, I want you to understand the basic treatment of the errors. So when the question says, here is the error, here is the mistake, you need to check, because the mistake can either be made by us as Sylvestish company, or it can be made by FNB. So depending on the error, you will know where to correct the error. So if the error has been made by us, obviously the error must be corrected in our books, either in the cash receipts or cash payments. But if the error has been found on the bank statement, this means that this error was made by FNB. So the error can only be corrected under the bank reconciliation statement. But I'll show you how to do that by using an exercise or a practical question at a later stage. Remember, like today I said, I'm not going to touch on anything practical, guys. I'm only going to share this basic information so that by the time when we engage ourselves in those practical exercises, we will have the basic or the foundation of what I'm trying to deliver at the moment. Are you all okay with the errors at the moment, ladies and gentlemen? Can I say yes? Yes. Hallelujah. Anything that can give me a signal or maybe a sense of the fact that you do understand. Thank you so much, Ashley. Thank you so much, Siabonga. Thank you so much, Atisan. Thank you so much. Very much appreciated. Very much appreciated. That was all about the error. So with the error again, I'm just going to focus a bit on the error sake. You see, now I'm just going to erase the whole thing here and make sure that I explain errors, because errors can be very, very, very confusing. Remember, guys, honestly speaking, I do have the slides for this. You know, I always give you slides, guys. No, I care about your future, because I know that if you progress in life, it means I also progressed. I will feel most honored by the time when you graduate, guys. If you know the feeling, you know, when I look at my students graduating and I know I was part of the process, a man of my caliber just becomes happy. Eh? I'm telling you, I'm just telling you the truth. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna erase this information and then make sure that I give you examples of the errors, because errors can be a bit confusing. But like I said, I've got notes for you on the slides, you know. But I'm telling you, after this, you will think that you don't even need slides because you understand what's going on. Listen now, slides and the textbook and the manuals are there to refer, okay, for reference purposes. So guys, for now, bear with me. I'm going to erase this information so that I can focus again on the explanation. Oh, guys, before I do that, do you think that you need a break? Let me know. Do you need a break, guys? Because for me, after these errors, I will finish. I'll release you guys so that I can go and do other things. But if you need a break, I can give a break. And when you come back, I continue. But if you can maybe try to hang on for some time and I give you examples of the errors and I'll say bye-bye. I can also say bye-bye in advance. It's Dan. Okay, thank you, Andy. Thank you, Dan. I can see. Thank you, Siabonga. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, guys, let me just finish and then I'll release you. Okay, no problem. You know how it works now. For me, it's not all about finishing. Huh? If I finish, the question is, do I understand? For me, it's like running a project. If my project must run for 1 year and I finish within 6 months, there's no need for me to continue the project. I finish and I start a new one. You know what I mean? So let's continue, guys. I just want to give you examples of errors, okay? So now, let's talk about the errors once again. Let me write my business again. You know the name of my business. This will be the Silvestish Company. Let me write it again. Silvestish. And then still I'm going to use FNB. Okay. Yes. And then I'm going to talk about the errors now, guys. I'm just trying to explain the errors once again. Remember, I said the errors can either be found on the bank statement or in our books. Let's say, for example, I'm just trying to give you examples of errors. Let's say, for example, in the CRJ, our accountant recorded 1,000 rand, which is incorrect. Accountant recorded CRD, which is incorrect, of 1,000. And the correct amount was 900. So can you see already in our books we have recorded 1,000? But the correct amount is how much? It's 900. Who can tell me? Did we overstate or understate the amounts? I'm just going to give you a few minutes. Did we overstate or understate the amounts? Just look at it and tell me. If you check at this situation, did we overstate or understate? We overstated. Thank you so much. Hey guys, you're on fire. We overstated. We overstated. So what must we do? We need to correct this error. But because we overstated, it means we need to record only the difference. Remember, already we recorded to how much? 1,000. So if you overstate, you need to correct the error in the opposite book. So in this case, we are going to correct the error. Correct the error in the CPJ. This is what I want you to understand. Remember, the amount is more in the CRJ. So the difference of how much, let's see how much is the difference. The difference is 100 rand, as you can see. So the difference here is 100 rand. So this 100 rand, like I said, this 100 rand is the one that I need to rectify. So because I've got more in the CRJ, so I must go and correct this error in the CPJ. So in the CPJ, I'm gonna go and record how much? 100 rand. What I'm trying to say is, if the amount is overstated in a particular journal, the correction must be recorded under what? The opposite book. So I've got more in the CRJ. It means I must go and take 100 rand out. So I must correct it in the CPJ, because CPJ is the opposite of CRJ. The same thing can apply under, let's say I overstated under CPJ. The difference will always be recorded in the what? In the CRJ. So I want you to get that, guys. I want you to get that logic first. As long as you overstated, the correction must always be done under the opposite book. That is a fact. Because you cannot go to the same book and try to put brackets. No, you're not. This is the olden way of dealing with those books. So you must just make sure that you take the difference and you put it under a different or an opposite book. Guys, do you understand what I just tried to say here? As long as you overstate it. Let me see, yes, yes, if you understand what I just said. Remember, guys, it's going to make more sense by the time when we take our exercises. Remember, guys, here we're just talking for now. Thank you so much. I appreciate feedback, guys. So let me give you another example whereby, okay, let me just change the color here. I want to give you another example. I'm just going to use CRJ again. CRJ. The amount is 500. It is incorrect. The correct amount is 200. What is the correct amount? 700. So we recorded under CRJ, we recorded 500 instead of recording what? 700. I know. I'm going to ask you an obvious question. Did you overstate or understate? Please tell me. Did we overstate or understate? Sorry, guys. My mouse. No, guys. My birthday, if you can donate me a mouse, I'll be happy. I'm joking. So is it overstated or understated, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much. Addison said understated. Andy, I think you meant understated, ne? You didn't mean understand. Okay, so I'm gonna write understated. I want it just as long as you understand this, okay? It means I understate it. So obviously, what is the difference? If you can check the difference here, it's going to be 200. The difference is 200. So the amount is understated 200. So you need to correct this error now. Why must I correct this error? Correct the error in the same book where is understated. So this must be the simple one. So obviously, where will I record this error? I'll record it in there. Does this make sense? So, and it makes sense because obviously I only recorded what? 500. I still have to record 200. Perfect, Andy. Thank you so much. Perfect answer. So, you can get this principle. As long as you understate, you are going to correct the error in the same book where you understate. But if you overstated, you will have to correct the error in the opposite book because in that book, you have got more. You must take amount in that book and take it to the other book so that you can set off the amounts, if you know what I mean. Guys, I hope you understand the errors here. The errors on the bank statement or the errors or from FNB, this is very simple, you'll see. Because you'll see a bank reconciliation that, remember I said you must record in the bank reconciliation. So a bank reconciliation looks like this. I think it looks, it depends on the, I think I'll double check. I think for us it's going to look like this. Yeah, because there some books have got different formats. Let me just use the one that I always use. So a bank reconciliation looks like this. Bank reconciliation statement, it looks like this. And now, and then it's going to have credit. This is how the bank state bank reconciliation statement will look like. Can you see now? And then thereafter, so if the error took place under, let's say for example, on the bank statement, I realized that the bank took 5,000 by mistake. So it means I must get it back. Can you see now? So it means, let's say if they took it out, remember on the bank statement when they take amount out by mistake, in other words, they dated me by mistake. So if they, I have to correct the error. So obviously that 2,000, if they took 2,000, I'll just come and put it on the credit side. This one is very easy. That 2,000 will just come here. If they dated me. So I can just, to be safe, I'll just say correction of error. And if there's a check number, I'll just put check number correction of error. You know, or you can just say amount wrongly or incorrectly debited. Can you know? So can you see it was incorrectly debited on the bank statement? What am I doing now? I'm fixing the error. I'm crediting this. So if they incorrectly gave me the money, obviously I'm gonna come and put it on the debit side. Can you see now? So for me, the error that is appearing on the bank statement is very easy to deal with because I just have to check what is the current situation with the mistake and I do the opposite. Does this make sense, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much, guys. Honestly speaking, this is what I wanted to give you as the theory. No. I'm just remember, and I'm not using the amount here. This is two different things. Don't mix them. Don't mix. This 200 is not this one. I just came with a random figure. That's why I said 2,000. It can be 200 if you want to put it, but it's not this 200. These are two different things. Okay, I'm just saying if the bank made a mistake of 2,000. So, but if you say in your case the bank made a mistake of 200, it's okay. You can put 200, but it doesn't mean that it's this 200. This 200 was different. Because the error took place in our books, it will not affect this. It will affect the. I don't know if you understand me, Andy. So what the error that took place in our business cannot come here. We only come here because the error took place on the bank statement. Thank you so much for that, Andy. Any other questions, guys?